Welcome to Disturbingly Cheap Reviews, back from a long break after being trapped in Cuba Gooding Jr.'s makeshift dungeon. Thank you all for sending help. One person's like wondering where I am. Thank you. Thank you very much for doing so. And speaking of horrible things I don't want to remember involving dungeons, let's discuss Dungeons & Dragons, The Book of Vile Darkness. Yes, the third in the vaunted D&D movie series decides to abandon all connections to the original two and attempt to build its own universe, much like a tabletop group of people desperately searching for friendship. In it, we follow Grayson, who is supposed to be the chosen one for a certain group, but is rejected by the big stone that they hold swords up to. Anyway, a band of evil sweeps in, killing every unnamed character, kidnapping Grayson's papa, and knocking out our excuse for a hero. Therefore, he goes to a town and joins a band of cannon fodder with a side of love interest for an adventure that has lines meant to resemble an homage to a D&D game. Personally, this is a problem for me when it comes to D&D movies. A D&D game, person comes up with a story and then other people interact within the story. But when you do a movie, it's one person writing one story, one specific way in which every character acts the way they want them to. However, this is not the worst thing about the movie. No, that would be the main characters. Grayson is unlikable. The rest of the adventurous crew are also unlikable. The combination of the both of them makes their adventures unlikable. This film doesn't recover from that, and in the end, it becomes a dull stretch of a runtime. I give it a D, because there's some semblance of good ideas, with some really decent CGI, especially for such a low-budget film. And there's one or two really good solid moments, but I just felt those were too far and few between. So it's not recommended unless you really do enjoy D&D, and are curious to see how a live-action version would work that doesn't have Marlon Wayans or Bruce Payne. And now, we crit hit a dragon on the way to spoilers. Hey! They kill a dragon by blowing up a ceiling, and that's the last time you see a dragon. Hey! There's one black character who's part of the main party, and he dies first. Hey! There's a girl who is built to be a beyond tough, independent woman, but in the end, it appears all she really needed was a good man. Hey! That guy in the creepy cloak who keeps talking in whispers and acting sort of evil ends up being evil. Hey, there is this opening animation, and you now know about as much of it as I do. Hey, the Book of Vile Darkness doesn't really matter because they wrap that up with an inanely short moment where the good guy's amulet lights up and kills all the bad guys. Hey, that's it. Thanks for listening. Apologies for the beyond long break. So until next time, never accept tea from Cuba Gooding Jr. Ever.